I'm planning another trip in our motorhome, but where to? We're unsure of the border restrictions within the new countries of the recently reformed Australis, previously known as Australia. I need clarification due to the division of our governments, which is now being ruled by what seems to be eight different countries within one continent. Gone is the former Australian Capital Territory as the glue holding all the states and territories together. Now Akbar, as a country, is saying Scott stuff all to do with scummerous anymore. The power has been redistributed to the eight new countries which were once mere states within Australia, but has evolved into their own entities in the new Australis. I'm hoping enough information can be gathered before the language changes yet again from country to country, because it's guaranteed to be even more confusing in time to come. It's taken me many years to get my head around the former Victoria, now Lochdanistan, referring to castle when the remainder of Australis pronounces it as castle. Okay, let's get back to planning this trip. We'll be leaving from the mid-north coast of Afghanistan, formerly New South Wales. With the constant changing rules with fines imposed on what you can do or say within the borders of Afghanistan, I'm sure as shit stinks the term New South Wales will be outlawed as yet another method of revenue raising in this, the most populated country within Australis. My first thought of a destination was to go somewhere where I haven't been before. Gutwennia sounds nice. It's coming up to summer, and I've never been overseas before, so it could be a good time to go on a cruise. That said, the Navigator has been to the then Tasmania in her teens. I, on the other hand, haven't been to Gutwennia, so it could be an interesting experience for both of us to share. Getting to Gutwennia does present another challenge as it involves navigation through the heart of Lochdanistan, which was once revered as Victoria. A possible upside is that the Navigator might be able to catch up with her family whilst we're in Lochdanistan, and again after the return cruise if our luck holds out. Unfortunately, from our current location, this would mean we'd have to traverse through Sydney. This could be a good thing because it may give us a chance to catch up with our two fully vaccinated sons who are currently under what could only be described as house arrest in the current lockdown. Is that the right term? Because they actually share an apartment together, so should that be an apartmental arrest? If anybody can clarify on this, please let us know by adding a comment with your thoughts and perhaps hit the subscribe and bell icon buttons to keep you up to date with our goings on. Also, if you're liking this video so far, be sure to click the thumbs up to give us a like, but don't waste your time by clicking the thumbs down button, because the governments of Australis are petitioning YouTube to take down this button in an effort to remove any negativity. Okay, so Gutwennia may not be the greatest destination at the moment, given that the rules in Lochdanistan are yet to be set in stone. So perhaps we should look at the former Queensland, now Palaszczuk, where we have some friends and more family that's well overdue for a visit. One such friend, who is profoundly deaf and lives on his own in the Northern Rivers area of Afghanistan, we could catch up with on the way, but communication with Tom could be an issue. Perhaps we should reconsider visiting Tom, because with our masks, he's not going to see what we're saying anyway. Then we could avoid the massive queues going into Palaszczuk with its own rules that seem to be changing on an hourly basis. Maybe we could reassess our entry point into Palaszczuk via a much smaller border crossing like Texas. We did this back in April of 2020 when Australis was still Australia and Palaszczuk was still Queensland. We were on our way to the then Western Australia, now Macca's, via Gunnerland. The Prime Minister of Macca's really started to go crackers back in 2020 when the signs of division in Australis first reared its ugly head. I must say at this point that Gunnerland, to clarify, is the old Northern Territory. Back then, Gunnerland had the most sensible approach to border crossings with a much simplified permit system, but I'm now unsure if that sensibility remains. Sorry, I got sidetracked again with history, so let's get back to planning this next trip. With Palaszczuk off the cards and in the too hard basket, I was thinking Gunnerland, but it's really starting to warm up there. That only leaves the Marshallese, formerly South Australia, or Akbar,
which we once knew as the Australian Capital Territory. Either way, these two destinations are just one step away from Afghanistan. However, the thought of going to Akbar, with its history and politics, just puts a bad taste in my mouth, and the thought of running into Scummo, who is now a tour guide that you just can't shut up, just makes me puke. So it's safe to say that Akbar is off the cards. Such a small place anyway, full of people with big heads. Seriously, one blink and you're past it. Okay, does that make the Marshallese a viable destination for our next trip? We're still going to have to arrange passports and border passes to get into the Marshallese, and considering we did some extensive sightseeing there only a few months ago whilst travelling back from Macca's, the memories are still fresh, despite the bad taste that Macca's left. When I think about it, Lochdanistan is still fresh in our minds. We got to see the navigator's parents and some other family and friends. So perhaps our next trip should be within a short radius of our summer home here in Afghanistan on the mid-north coast. Staying closer to home may have some benefits if our sons are ever released from their exile. Of all the people we could visit, the ones we miss the most are our boys. And as much as we miss our parents, siblings, and other family and friends, nothing beats hugging your own offspring. This rant is dedicated to our two sons, with whom we have been denied our regular contact, and look forward to spending time with if sanity is restored. To the people watching and listening to this video who have no sense of humour, all I can say is, give us back the Australia we once knew.